Do you have Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis and are being faced with surgery? Wondering if you should get it or not? Well, I will highlight the advantages of having surgery and the possible risks, so stay tuned to find out everything you need to know about surgery and IBD. Welcome back to my channel, the only place for Crohn's and colitis tips, tricks, and information. So make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the bell to be notified every time I post a video, as well as if you want to join an exclusive community of people who receive my personal tips and tricks on living with Crohn's disease, then make sure you sign up to my newsletter by visiting the link in the description box below. So before we get started, just like Crohn's and colitis affecting everyone differently, everyone who needs surgery for their IBD will need it for different reasons. And the risks of each surgery vary depending on the type and the complexity of the operation. I've personally had 3 operations for strictures because of my Crohn's, and each one was different from the last. But without delaying things further, let's just get straight into things. So advantage number 1 is pain relief. Look, there is no doubt that suffering from complications of Crohn's disease is painful. And yes, you will be in pain after the operation because that is only natural. And you will be given medication to handle that pain. But the main priority is not being in pain because of your IBD. And so that is one of the main advantages of having the operation. Now, pain is one of the worst things to go through because it affects your mood, how you are around people, and can cause sleep deprivation, which not only makes you more tired, but even more cranky and can make fatigue even worse. So no more pain means better sleep and better health in general. Advantage number 2 is you would be going number 2 less frequently. Now, depending on the type of surgery you have, for example, if you are having a stoma created, then most definitely you will stop going number 2 the conventional way, and so there's no more need to spend hours on end in the bathroom. Number 3 is surgery can relieve your symptoms and so can help reduce the amount of time you're experiencing things like diarrhea, constipation, or even nausea and vomiting. So this can certainly help with managing fatigue as well, as you won't be going up in the night constantly to the bathroom. Now, number 4, once you've recovered from surgery, you hopefully tend to start feeling better and get your appetite back. So eating more and more of a variety of foods in your diet post-surgery can help in gaining weight, which can be so hard if you have Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis. Number 5, surgery can make it more likely for you to be able to reduce the medications that you are taking, which means you will experience less side effects, which is a massive bonus as some side effects can be worse than the original symptoms. Number 6 is no doubt you'll have an improved quality of life because you're not experiencing symptoms or experiencing less symptoms than you were before. So your quality of life will be improved greatly. Now, the general risks of having surgery, such as a risk of infection, having general anesthetic, and the risk of bleeding still apply here. Now, more specific IBD risks of surgery includes those like an anastomotic leak. Now, when 2 parts of your intestine are sewn back together, that joint is called anastomosis. And if not sewn together tightly, can leak your bowel contents into your abdomen. And so this can lead to infection. Other complications can include becoming anemic if you've lost a lot of blood because of the operation. Now, there could be damage to other surrounding structures where you were being operated on, and scar tissue could cause adhesions and can cause your intestines to stick together. Now, having surgery is never risk-free, and as said at the beginning of the video, each surgery is different and will have their own associated risks. So it's important that you discuss this with your doctor and surgeons in depth. And there you have it, a brief summary of the advantages of having surgery for Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis. Now make sure you check out these videos for more useful tips, tricks, and information on Crohn's and colitis. Hit that subscribe button and the bell to be notified every time I post a video, as well as leaving a like and a comment if you enjoyed this and found it useful. And I can't wait to see you all in the next episode.